Hi there. Welcome to Age and Opportunity. For more information about our programs, please see our website details at the bottom of the screen. This is the first of a series of videos that we decided we would make in order to look at ways in which we can do things in these strange times, do things to help us to either feel better or stay feeling well. Now, for some of us, that's something we're used to, and for others of us, that might prove something of a challenge. We want to look at how we deal with the kinds of things life can throw at us and whether we're able to, for instance, bounce back or not. Now, bounce back is just another way of referring to the term resilience. Resilience is that kind of strength or feeling that we have, sometimes in greater amounts and sometimes in lesser amounts, but it's the feeling we have that we can deal with whatever has been landed at our feet or in our lap and get on with it and still feel good or okay in ourselves. So the one of the really important things to remember is that this feeling of resilience isn't necessarily something that we're just born with. For sure, some of us are born with lots of it and others of us are born with less of it. But either way, what's really important to realize is that this is something we can learn. So over the next few weeks, we're going to look at ways in which we can examine ourselves, look at our degree of resilience, or indeed sometimes feeling that we have very little resilience, but looking at that and looking at either what we have around us in terms of that we can call on for support, or looking at things that we can do to increase our sense of both being able to call and look for support, but also being able to rely on ourselves. So I really hope that you join us for this journey. It's something that we really hope will be of use to everybody, including myself, because all of the exercises that we will be showing you are ones that I would recommend that every single one of us should do every now and again. Maybe every few months, every 6 months, and indeed when things get back to normal, we might even look at using these exercises with our friends and family. But particularly at the moment, if you are, for instance, cocooning or living with somebody else, some of these exercises could well prove to be really fruitful for you and whoever it is you're sharing with to do together or separately and then talk about it later.
Welcome to the first of a series of short videos on the theme of resilience, or building resilience. A lot has been written about resilience in lots of areas. Resilience of individuals, resilience of families, of groups and communities, the resilience of institutions. But for the moment, a good place to start would be to consider, what does the word resilience mean to me? Or you might consider the following questions. What gets me out of bed in the morning? What keeps me going throughout the day? Where do I get my energy from? Don't worry, we'll return to those questions again. You might have heard it said, life doesn't get easier or more forgiving. We get stronger and more resilient. Do we? It's an interesting statement. Because I think it is true, as someone said, the further up the mountain we climb, more of the horizon we can see. As we age, we get a little bit more perspective. But is it true that as we age, we also become more resilient? Nature presents us with many images of resilience. I love this image of the tree bending in the wind. It's said that if a tree doesn't bend, it breaks. That tells us something about resilience, the need to be flexible or adaptable, the need to avoid being rigid. Here's another lovely image highlighting nature's extraordinary resilience, a plant emerging through the cracks in the rock. Who knows what new possibilities might spring out of adversity? Or take this image of stones in the stream, the solidity of rock in face of the perpetual flow of water. Yes, images of resilience are all around us in nature. The ebb and flow of water, one of the most powerful. But it's not only in nature that resilience is to be found. It's everywhere in music as well. Have a listen to this song, which I'm sure you've heard before, while keeping in mind the idea of resilience.
No matter, 'cause there's something inside so strong. I know that I can make it, though you're doing me wrong, so wrong. You thought that my pride was gone. Oh no, something inside so strong. Oh, something inside so strong.
Labby Seyfried's song, released in 1987, is a powerful one. It highlights the power of music. Music fuels resilience. The insistent beat and repeated phrase, something inside so strong, is like a blood transfusion, an injection of energy, hope, defiance, resolve. But the song works not only on the level of the individual, but of the group. In its call to brothers and sisters everywhere, the song highlights the importance of resilience, not just as an individual resource, but as a collective force. This is where music can be incredibly powerful in bringing people together, fostering a sense of solidarity or connection. Think of the celebrated song, "You'll Never Walk Alone," sung by Liverpool supporters at Anfield for every match. Myths, stories, songs are powerful tools for building resilience. Phrases like "you'll never walk alone" or "something inside so strong" can act like a wake-up call, instilling a kind of mental strength. Yes, what makes Labby Seyfried's song so interesting in the context of resilience is that it poses one very important question. What is this something inside so strong? Is it a feeling, a conviction, a steely determination, a refusal to give up, or give in, a desire to stand up and be counted, a willingness to go the extra mile, an unwavering belief in oneself or in others, a certain mental strength? Yes, the phrase "something inside so strong" is a good one for resilience, because it speaks of an inner strength, call it mental strength. And this mental strength is a capacity that can be developed. Resilience, then, is not a character trait that is determined, but a mental capacity that can be developed. It is not something fixed, in other words, but something fluid that can be fostered, developed, cultivated, enhanced. And it is this sense of resilience that underlies Age&Opportunity's Changing Gears program. It is possible to build resilience. Building resilience, for us then, you might say, is a form of mental fitness. It involves training your brain or strengthening your mind or fostering awareness to deal with whatever setbacks or challenges life puts before you. Looking at resilience in the context of mental strength highlights two key things. One, resilience is ordinary, not extraordinary. And two, resilience is about thoughts, behaviors, and actions, and can be learned by anyone. In fact, all of us, as we shall see, are engaged in thoughts, behaviors, and actions that promote resilience, at least to some extent. The idea is to develop these through practical skills, tools, strategies, techniques that help us to cope better with setbacks, adversity, conflict, difficulties, and challenges. In the next few videos, we'll have a look at some of these resilience-building tools or techniques and what they have to offer. Meanwhile, you might recall those earlier questions and what they tell you about your own sense of resilience.
As I said a few minutes ago, resilience is something that we can learn. And I just thought it might be a good idea to think about it like a muscle. The more we use our muscles, the stronger they get. Sometimes they even increase in size. For instance, I'm sure that's why so many people go to the gym. But, you know, it's something that we should really, really keep developing and keep using. Because if we let it go still, it could get rusty. And that's one of the things we always want to avoid. At Age and Opportunity, we have this phrase, which is keep moving. Keep moving physically, keep moving emotionally, and keep moving mentally, so that we're constantly, or in not maybe not constantly, but as often as we can, stimulating ourselves, trying to learn new things, but also keeping our body and soul moving, so that in fact, the chance of it getting stuck and rusty is reduced.